In the beginning, there was medical legend Heart Sounds and Murmurs, a groundbreaking game show where contestants tested their skills to identify heart sounds. Many people took on the challenge, but only a select few claimed legendary status. But it became clear there was a problem. Legends found that the visual cues made the game too easy. One man came forward and said the visual cues had to go. Others rallied around, and it became clear that things needed to change. In this episode, there will be no easy ride, no visual helping hand. The difficulty level has been set to pro. I am the Quizmaster, and this is Medical Legend Extreme. The show has simple rules, 8 multiple choice questions, and 1 shot to prove your expertise. Your score at the end will determine your overall rank, so if you have what it takes, get your pen and paper ready, and let's play Medical Legend Extreme. Question 1. So, a brief word of warning. You will be played a 10-second audio clip, so make sure you are poised and ready to classify what you hear. This will be followed by 4 possible answers where only one of them will be correct. Are you ready? Let's play. As always, I like to ease you in with something that's fairly straightforward. You review a patient as part of a routine medical. Listen to the heart sounds and select the correct description. Is the correct answer the S4 heart sound, normal heart sounds, an ejection click, or the S3 heart sound? And the correct answer is normal heart sounds. Let's use a graphical representation to visualize this answer. So this was the S1 and S2 heart sounds, which are normal. Let's move on. Question 2. Meet a 4-year-old with Down syndrome. She has shortness of breath and recurrent chest infections. Listen to the heart sounds and select the correct description. Is the correct answer a pansystolic murmur, an ejection systolic murmur, a late diastolic murmur, or a machinery murmur? The correct description is machinery murmur. Let's take a look at a sound wave so we can understand why this was a machinery murmur. The machinery murmur classically spans systole and diastole, and for this patient, this is the machinery murmur of the patent ductus arteriosus, which is one of the cardiac abnormalities associated with Down syndrome. Question 3. Your next patient is an 80-year-old male with shortness of breath, dizzy spells, and a slow rising pulse. Listen to the heart sounds and select the most likely diagnosis. Is the correct answer aortic stenosis, mitral regurgitation, aortic regurgitation, or mitral stenosis? Think carefully about your answer. And the correct answer is aortic stenosis. Let's take a look at another visual to illustrate why this was aortic stenosis. So this was the ejection systolic murmur of aortic stenosis, and the history suggested this with the shortness of breath, dizzy spells, and the slow rising pulse. Let's move on. Question 4. A 76-year-old lady presents with shortness of breath. You listen to the heart sounds and hear a murmur that radiates to the left axilla. Select the correct diagnosis. Here is the murmur. So, is the correct diagnosis aortic stenosis, mitral stenosis, mitral regurgitation, or aortic regurgitation? And the correct answer is mitral regurgitation. Let's visualize this with an illustration. Congratulations to all those that got this question correct. Here we have a pansystolic murmur which radiates to the axilla. This is mitral regurgitation. Wow, so we're halfway through this episode of Medical Legend and the stakes are high. Remember, it's not just about getting the diagnosis right, it's about securing your place in medical history. Will you become a medical legend? Question 5. Your next patient is a 75-year-old with shortness of breath and dizziness. On examination, you find a collapsing pulse and the following murmur. Select the most likely diagnosis. Here is the murmur. And here are your four possible answers for question 5. Remember that only one of them is correct. Is the most likely diagnosis mitral stenosis, atrial septal defect, aortic regurgitation, or tricuspid regurgitation? I'm so anxious right now, I can hear my own heart pound. The correct answer is aortic regurgitation. Here is another illustration so you can visualize the murmur. So a collapsing pulse in the presence of an early diastolic murmur is very likely to be aortic regurgitation. Let's move on to question 6. Your next patient is a 60-year-old with new-onset atrial fibrillation. On examination, he has a flushed face and a tapping apex beat. Listen to the heart sound and select the most likely diagnosis. Is the correct answer aortic stenosis, mitral stenosis, the S4 heart sound, or the atrial gallop? The correct answer is mitral stenosis. Let's add in a visual cue so we can review why this is the correct answer. Mitral stenosis is the correct answer here because we have the classic mid-diastolic murmur with an opening snap, and the history gives us features: new onset atrial fibrillation, a flushed face which is likely a malar rash, and a tapping apex beat. These are all classic presenting features of mitral stenosis. Question 7. you examine a patient with new-onset atrial fibrillation, listen to the heart sounds, and select the most likely diagnosis. Is the correct answer ventricular septal defect, the S4 heart sound, atrial septal defect, or aortic regurgitation? The correct answer is atrial septal defect. Let's visualize this with an illustration. This was a tough question, but we have here an ejection systolic murmur with splitting of the S2. This is a typical presentation for atrial septal defect. Well, we have reached the nerve-wracking moment of truth. The tension is so thick you could cut it with a scalpel. I hope you have your stethoscopes ready, because it's time for the final question. Listen closely to the heart sounds, and let's find out who's got the rhythm to claim the title of medical legend. Question 8. You review a patient with congestive heart failure. Listen to the heart sounds and select the correct description. Prepare yourself. Focus. Here are the heart sounds. Is the correct answer the S4 heart sound, normal heart sounds, an ejection click, or the S3 heart sound? And the correct answer is the S3 heart sound. A special congratulations to everybody that has got this far. For one last time, let's look at a visual cue to understand this answer, and then we'll tally up the scores and find out who has got that legendary title. So this was the S3 heart sound, which can be associated with congestive heart failure. And this brings us to the end of the question, so tally up your scores and let's find out what your ranking is. So for 3 correct answers, you will score the ranking of medical student. If you manage to get 4 correct answers, you've achieved the ranking of house officer. If you got 5 correct answers, you're a specialist registrar. 6 correct answers gives you the ranking of MD. If you've got 7 correct answers, you are a professor. But only those who scored 8 correct answers can claim the title of medical legend. Congratulations to all those who have aced the quiz and claimed the prestigious title. It's time to celebrate your victory and bask in the glory of your medical prowess. And to those who fell short this time, fear not, for legends are not made in a day. Keep learning, keep growing, and who knows, maybe the next episode of Medical Legend will be your shining moment. And if you enjoyed watching this, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell, and you'll be notified when more great shows like this become available. This is your Quizmaster signing off. Until next time, stay legendary. I'll see you in the next show.